look at one more setup. Again, if you were here for the Tarikoplata mesocycle, you should know this move. For those that weren't here, we'll just quickly go for it. So I win the underhook, we sit through. This was the advantageous position that we wanted to get to. I'm going to push this down, same setup as the last move. And from there, my windshield wiper, my left, and replace it with my right. Get the card on the side again as I step. Once I get to there, he opened up the lapel, tied up Carr's wrist. Now from this position, I grab the pants, pull Carr's knees towards the mat, and I swung my head this way and brought my leg over his wrist. Let go of the lapel and found my thigh. And I put my hand on the mat. Starting to curl my right foot towards the shoulder line, and then to finish from here I raise my left elbow and wipe my butt on Carl's stomach as I bring it towards the mat. Yeah. So from broken scarf, super chill, push it down. Again, last time we just got into this position. This time a windshield wiper step over in the last position. Again, you know, your basic submissions from here is obviously the Chimera. And then I'm looking to put my elbow on the mat and sit through. The car's probably... it's probably going to get hand to hand. So rather than trying to break this grip, we're going to take advantage of it. Half of these resistance. This comes over, just bring it over the wrist. Now there's tension. Remember we talked about tension in limbs? If there's tension in limbs, they're a lot easier to move. Pull his knees over, lean one way, and I want the back of my knee over Carl's wrist. And then I let go of the lapel and find my thigh. But when we get to there, it becomes a battle. When I was going for this, it becomes a battle for Carl to try and free this arm. I want it pinned. Why? Because I want to be able to get my leg over here. It becomes significantly harder if I'm pinning this and Carl gets his arm free. Once his arm's free, he'll possibly grab his lapel with that hand, keep it secure, and now he's a free hand. And his goal is, as I try to get my leg over his body for the target body, he's going to make grips in my pants here. But now we're going to take advantage of that. So rather than fighting for the target body, that crucifix is there. I just need an open elbow there. How do we get that? You just bring my leg out. He's still hanging on to that. Make sense? So once he brings that out, I'm going to sit him up and bring my hip from beside his left ear to beside his right ear, and I'm just going to sit back into the crucifix. The good thing is, this is already tied up. So now from there, bring it on top of me. Last time we looked at this. This time maybe I just couldn't get the angle to come over his right shoulder, so we're coming over the left shoulder. So we talked about if we're coming over this side, it's a thumb down grip. Use my elbow, get underneath Carr's chin. Let's just say it's loose. And now I'm trying to finish. And I don't have the connection. We talked about it's hard. You know, I don't want to let go of this to try and re-grab here because then this arm's free. So from that position, all we're going to do from here is we're going to shrimp out and I'm going to bring my left knee through at the back of the shoulder. Just filling space, right? If you're not getting the connection of the choke, okay, we just put some part of our body and fill that space, so you're just getting the connection back again. So again, from super chill, we're here, push this down, windshield wiper. If I'm going for the Tarikoplata there, I'll windshield wiper this side. Bring up into the north side. Start attacking the Chimera. You get the reaction of this. That's when I'm going for the Tarikoplata. When he makes that, I just tie it up, pull the knees down, swing it over. In. But in the battle of this, he's gonna be bumping and trying to free this arm. That makes sense? Your players will want this arm free. So now he'll secure under the lapel just to keep his arm safe, because if I have this and Carr's not grabbing his lapel and he's trying to stop me getting my leg over, I'm not going to the crucifix. I'm going back. Why? Because this arm's floating. He's made a connection again. Yeah, now he's got this arm free. And we always want to be not trying to force one submission. You know, we spend a lot of time in this Tarikoplata, but it just becomes very, very difficult to get my leg over his body when he's got a free arm. He will grab that leg every single time. So it makes more sense to go down the crucifix. What do I need? I need space under that armpit. So if he grabs the pants to stop my leg from coming over, I just bring that leg out wider. When I do, space opens up. Now I need a little bit of profile there. And I'm kind of on the wrong side of his head. I want my hips more on this side to get the crucifix. So from there, I just sit him up a little bit. Bring my knee under, and now I'm falling back into the crucifix again. Only now, I've already got that grip. So, landing over the left shoulder, that's a thumb down grip. If he's too far down, I just pull him up a little bit, and then I pass this under. If the lapel is loose and I feel I can't get it, it's really the connection. So I'm just planting my right foot on the mat, sitting card up and shrimping back and bringing my knee so it's popped over his left shoulder from there. See by now there's tension in the lapel. No, it's there. Okay, let's play with that guy's head.